'twas the night before Margember, and all through the cubes, not a creature was stirring, not even the Largo group. The stockings were hung by Rebecca with care, in hopes that dear Manta soon would be there. When out in the parking lot arose such a clatter, Cole sprung from his chair to see what was the matter. Away to the windows Desiree flew with a flash, tore open the shutters and threw open the sash. Then what to my wondering eyes should show up but a BMW sedan and an adorable black pup. With a strong Rocky-like driver and his sidekick with paws, I knew in a moment this must be Cashflow Claws. He was dressed in all green from his head to his foot, and his clothes were somewhat tarnished with Philly pebbles and soot. A bundle of cash he had flung on his back, and he looked like a chef just opening his sack. With a wink of his eye and a twist of his head, I knew in an instant we had nothing to dread. He walked to the office reviewing P&Ls, making clients profitable with help from the elves. "It's been a tough road," he muttered as he picked up a P-Mix. "Margins are tight, especially in Phoenix." "The answer's in the food," he said, "though I am no guru. Sometimes even the best owners must rework their menu." Taking a bite of a meatball and a sip of an IPA, his visit was over. He had more margins to slay. And laying a finger to the side of his nose, he called for his pup, and back in the car, they both drove. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight,
"Profits to all, and to all a good night."